In the words of Elsa, let it go. Hey, teacher friends. Welcome to Sutton Teaches Secondary. I'm Miss Sutton, but you can call me MarQuitta. And here we talk about those strategies for teaching at those high need schools. We talk about planning for ELA classrooms, and we just talk about teacher life. And that is exactly what we're going to talk about today. Teacher life. Because, you know, we are reaching that time of year where life gets a little crazy. It's not quite spring break yet, and we are like, it's rough. And I get it. We have all been there. Maybe you're there, or maybe you're almost there. And so before it gets too out of hand, let's reel ourselves back on in. I have some ideas that I think will help you stay a bit more sane and just kind of help you get organized. Also, keep in mind, I'm not going to tell you the things that everybody else has told you already. We've got some new ideas, and not that those things are bad, but you know, hey, you didn't click on my video because you wanted something that everybody else said. So let's talk about it. So my very first idea for helping you to just stay sane and more together during the school year is to go on a walk. Yes. Now, the reason why I say go on a walk, or if you're a runner, I want to be like you one day, go on a run. The reason why I say that is because it's a very repetitive motion. It's something that's good for your body, but it's not something you've got to think about too much, right? You're not thinking about where the weights have to be lifted or anything like that. That's why this is a much better form of exercise when you're trying to get yourself back a little, trying to get things a little more together or organized in your brain. Think about it. When you normally got to school, you more than likely drove there or you commuted there, which means that you had time to really decompress. You had time to think through ideas and just kind of process, because being a teacher means that you're doing lots of things in your brain at one time. Or on the way home, you had a moment to reflect on your practice, to see what you did well, think about why something went well, or think about this one kid and how you're trying to reach this one kid and nothing's working. And you kind of process ideas, and it helps you to think through and find something that's like, amazing. Now, we don't have that because we're teaching from home. So our commute is a walk from the bed. So if you build in some time to walk or run, either in the morning or after work, it gives you the chance to kind of process ideas. And guess what? It's good for your body. How can you go wrong with that? Even if it's 15 or 20 minutes a day, that little bit of time will really help you with processing your ideas and helping you to be a bit more sane and just a bit more organized in your brain. Now, my second idea is brain dumps. I'm normally someone who organizes my ideas and my thoughts with to-do lists, right? Like, do this, do that. I'm that kind of woman. However, in this virtual space, to-do lists are not working. And it just feels like my to-do lists are becoming like longer and longer. And then I'm putting all kinds of things on my, I don't know, it's just not working. And if you're someone like me and that's normally how you organize yourself, maybe you need something a little different. A brain dump is great because it helps to just get everything out there. So what I strongly suggest is before you start planning out your week, just dump everything out, write it all down. Write down your ideas, write down your thoughts. If it comes in your brain and it's related to school or school adjacent, write it down. And then you can take all of those ideas and organize them based on what they are. So for me, I usually have a section related to like plans and ideas for plans, because I'm always thinking of like, ooh, I could do this in my classroom, or I could do that, or maybe I should try this. I also use that to help make my to-do list. Or sometimes some of the things on there can just be a quick email that I write really quick and knock those things out. And it helps me feel more accomplished and kind of check those things off in my brain. And everything isn't just kind of getting meshed and mixed up all over the place. And you're actually feeling like you're getting things done. So dump your brain, pour everything out, and use that to help you really organize your ideas and the thoughts going on in your head. My third idea for keeping yourself sane is to set cutoff times. Now, I know you're thinking like, yeah, I'm working from home, I'm totally working less, But when I talk to my other teacher friends, a lot of them are saying they're working more. Why? Because you're home, you're in your workspace. Normally, you can physically cut off your workspace. We cannot do that right now. And so we have to, in our heads and in our actions, cut ourselves off. And so that might mean setting yourself a work time limit and saying, I'm gonna spend an hour or spend time until this time. What's done is done. It might also mean talking about shopping, stopping that after a while. Because sometimes we get so excited, we're talking to our teacher friends, and then that becomes like our whole conversation all night long. Nope, cut it off. Give yourself a time limit, and then after that, don't talk about it. Talk about something else. Let yourself be consumed by other things. Enjoy a wonderful show. Go walk, run, do something. Do whatever you enjoy doing, but cut yourself off. And I tell you this, if you have good teacher friends or good people that you talk shop with, they will not be offended when you stop responding at a certain time, right? Because they're going to respect your boundaries. The problem is you have got to respect your boundaries. In the words of Elsa, let it go. And my last idea is to take the day off. It's not revolutionary, but sometimes you just need to hear that. And the reason why I say that is because I know me, especially in my first years of teaching, I felt so guilty about taking the day off. I would say, oh no, it's gonna mess me up. I don't know how it's gonna affect my pacing. It's just gonna be worse by the time I come back. Now I have more work to do, whatever the case. I would come up with all kinds of reasons why it was not a good idea for me to take the day off. Now I realize how important those days off are. Sometimes you need it, but there are two reasons why you might need one. So listen carefully. One, you might need the day off to plan. If you need the day off to plan, do not take a personal day for that if you can avoid it. So what I mean is, if you are a new teacher or a new word teacher, there probably is some kind of clause or provision at your school to allow you to take a planning day. That way, you're not using your personal time to do work. Talk to your teacher mentor or whoever's over the new teacher program and ask if that provision is available. Maybe you are not a new teacher, so that does not apply to you, but there's so many kinds of options that you can opt into or ask about for a planning day. I mean, the worst that could happen is they tell you no. And then in that case, then you do have to take a personal day. You just need a mental health day. You are not going to do any work related to school. None. Don't do it. Mm-mm. Here's what you're going to do. Instead, you're going to plan for that day. So you're going to put it in the time of the week and the place in your unit that is most optimal for you. You are going to plan your sub lesson, but you are also going to plan the lessons around it. So when you come back, you're gonna have that lesson already planned. You're gonna be ready to go. If you don't do that, then you're gonna use your day off that's supposed to be for mental health day to get work done. And that's not what we're doing. So recharge yourself by being prepared for your day off and planning ahead of time. Now, speaking of all this planning, you might be thinking like, oh, I need to get my planning together because I'm taking my mental health day. Or maybe you just need to get some planning together because it's that time of day. And if that's the case, watch these videos here. They will definitely help you with getting your planning done. And if you made it this far, we're teacher friends. You need to just press that subscribe button and like this video so that we can continue to be teacher friends and learn from one another. And I definitely look forward to seeing you next time. And remember, you are amazing.